Okay, back again with the second part. Now we make the actions dynamic. And for this to happen, there is the action widget. For example, I want to use the action send widget to create a notification. Yeah, so I want to use action send message to notify something. Control C. Let's say we want to have an open action. So if the open button is clicked, then it should show a notification that the open button was clicked. So I say command open was created. Okay, then we need a sample notifications tiddler because this one is used as a template and we want to give it the okay, then notify command. Yeah. So now we need to assign this action to the open button. Yeah? So we want to have a new parameter which is called open actions, which default is nothing or has nothing. Then C, then the buttons, in this case the show button. Can use this variable. Think there's no. Is it needed? I don't know, but I save. So the open actions, and the open actions is done here. Yeah, if you have a look at the button widget. The button widget can handle actions. Where is it? Actions. Yeah. Yeah. So if you give actions to the button widget, it can activate them. Yeah. Even they are called like this. So now we have a little problem here because if we want to have open actions and call a macro again, this is not possible, yeah, because TiddlyWiki can't handle this. So that's why we need the macro call widget, which uses the name and chooses different parameters. So state, we name the parameters now. We want to have open text and close text and the open actions. And now it is possible to call macros. So we call the open actions macro. Open actions macro. Let's have a look. Yeah, open was activated. This one close. Oops, why not? Because we didn't define it in that way. So this has no actions assigned. And that's important. So we have open actions, we can have close actions, we can have delete actions, and so on. Yeah? And that is basically everything what happens within the Toggle Me macro. Yeah? There are a little bit more definitions to create unique names. Yeah? So there is a qualify by title, so it creates a unique name for the title and the current tiddler. then a title and list item, then a title and current title and list item. Yeah. This we have discussed already in the other videos, how to create different dynamically created names. Yeah. And all the rest is exactly the same what we did here. Yeah. It's just a little bit more dynamic, so every parameter can be overwritten. Yeah. But the mechanism is exactly the same as I showed you here. So you can see there's open text, close text, open actions, close actions. Then there are some icons, open icon, close icon. Yeah, that's it. Then there is the toggle OK cancel button, which we had already. There we had to overwrite the different texts. Yeah. What else is there? Then there is the toggle OK cancel delete button. Yeah. So, as I said, the mechanisms are exactly the same. Now you can create stuff like this on your own. And as I said, I also wanted with this project, I also wanted to have a look if different patterns come up. Yeah? And this toggle me was one of them. Yeah? So I probably will create a new plugin with this one, and yeah, even improve it a little bit if it is possible. Yeah? So that's basically it for this video, and play a little bit with it. There is no attachment because you have to write this on your own to experience the possibilities. So play a little bit with it. It's really funny. Have fun.